Welcome to the USF Health 25 Live Space Request System. This video tutorial will walk you through how to request a location to host your event. We will be requesting a location for a recurring event taking place on multiple days. Let's log in. To access the login page, head to the USF Health homepage. Scroll to the bottom of the page in the For You section. Click on the 25 Live link. This takes you to the USF Health 25 Live website. Here, you will find the login button, along with helpful information regarding USF Health 25 Live, such as tutorials, important scheduling dates, and other 25 Live related resources. Once you are logged in, you will see your 25 Live account homepage. Okay, let's get started. On the homepage, click the Create an Event button. This takes you to the 25 Live event form. Enter your event information. Some fields are required, but some are not. Most fields are self-explanatory, but there is a brief description of each field if you click the information icon. Sponsoring organization refers to your department or academic group. It's a pre-populated search term enabled list. Type in your department name or just a keyword. We'll type in nursing. Select the option that most closely aligns with your department or program. Notice the star icon. Once you locate your organization, click the star icon. Your organization will now appear at the top of the list without the need to search the database. If there are more than one sponsoring organization, you can add additional organizations in the co-sponsoring organizations text box, but this is not required. Now enter the amount of people you expect to attend. In the event promotional information text box, you can provide information like a description of the event. This is not required, but can help give other 25 Live users helpful information regarding your event, particularly the location approver. Choose the date of your event by clicking on the calendar. Scroll through until you find your desired date. Be sure to select the date and time of your very first meeting. Do not put the end date as the date of your last meeting. Click the calendar icon to change the date. Click the time field to change the time. Below this section is where you will set up your meeting pattern and select the dates and times of your additional meetings in this recurring series. If your meeting will meet every week on Thursdays, choose weekly. Or every month on the third Monday, choose monthly. If your meeting has no pattern and meets sporadically, you will click on all of the meeting dates from the provided calendar. If any of your dates have a different time than the initial date, click the View Occurrences link. Click on the times and edit as needed. If you need to remove any of your meeting dates, click the Remove Occurrence link. Now, let's choose a location. You can search by location name if you know which room you want, or you can type in the building prefix to see a full listing of all of the rooms within that building. If the location is available for all of your meeting dates, you will have a blue reserve button in the left-hand column. If it is not available at all, the left-hand column will state unavailable. If the room is available for some but not all of your meeting dates, you can select the Reserve Available link to request the room for the dates it is available. Click the View Occurrences link to see what dates are available and what dates you still need a location. Continue searching for another room that is available for your remaining dates. Scroll back to the search section, and this time, we'll search by capacity. Be careful not to overbook. Include and remove occurrences as needed. Depending on the event type you chose, you may have some additional questions to answer, like whether or not you are going to serve alcohol. Be sure to answer any required questions. If there are no questions, just keep scrolling. If you would like to add comments for the room approver to see, you can add them here. It is best to email the approvers directly to ensure a response. In the last section, you must click the I agree checkbox signifying that you understand that the use of the space requested is governed by the regulations and policies of USF. Click Save to submit your request. Congratulations! Your event has been successfully submitted to the location approver. Remember, your location request has not been finalized until the approver reviews all the information you provided and assigns the requested location. Now, navigate to the Home tab in 25 Live. In the Your Upcoming Events box, click the link that leads to all of the events you have requested. Find the event you are looking for and click the Event Name link. This is the event information page. There are two areas to look and see if your requested location has been assigned. First, select the Details tab. There is a blue box next to your requested location at the top right of the screen. Then the location has been assigned for your event. If you do not see any locations listed or a blue cube, then your requested location has not been assigned. You can also navigate to the Occurrences tab. This page is especially helpful if you have a multi-day event or multiple location requests. Again, if you see your requested locations with a blue box next to them, your location requests have been approved. If you see a gray box next to your requested location, then your request is still awaiting approval. For more information about USF Health 25 Live, visit the USF Health 25 Live homepage at health.usf.edu/25Live.